present to win. If I call your stub number, immediately let me know if you're in the ballpark, because we're not going to have a whole lot of time. We're going to go in order.
209817 is my ticket number.
Of our winners will have a chance to pick the uniform that they want. We're going to give you a certificate. At the end of the year, you can come back to the office and pick up your jersey. Are you ready?
You're giving away free jerseys.
First stub number, ticket number 210047.
No good.
210047.
No good. We're looking for 209817.
All right, just come down here and then through the gate up to the home dugout. All right, ticket number 187750.
No good.
209528.
So close, but no good.
209534.
Nope.
All right, Jeffrey, come on down.
Not a winner there either. And he's got one more to go.
I guarantee you, Joe Koble's not going to win. 210037. Ticket number 210045. All right, that's three down and two to go. Ticket number 205166.
There's somebody over there won on that one.
Okay, that's our fourth one. Ticket number 210001. Is that yours? Okay, come on down. We need all of our winners right down here on the field.
Yeah, I didn't win. Yeah. Better luck next time. That's the way out of the park, right there. It's Wednesday afternoon. Now this might look a little unfamiliar to a North Carolina vacation to you, because I've been doing mostly cities. But I took a 3-hour drive out to Wilmington, North Carolina. This is Wrightsville Beach. And in a couple minutes, you're going to see the beach. It's a seaside resort. Looks a lot like the New Jersey Shore. And I'm going to be here for the next 45 minutes. Shortage of tractor trailers down there, that's for sure. Those those are crickets chirping that you hear. Wrightsville Beach. The Atlantic Ocean. Over here where the lifeguard is, there's a little thing in the back of his lifeguard station that tells you what the ocean's like today. By the color of the flag, you can tell. And the flag is red today, so that means danger. Green would be calm, yellow would be caution, red danger, and black is no lifeguard. Yeah, I'm on the beach. No, I'm not in the water. Wonderful smell of the ocean. Not in the water, but I'm pretty close to it. Wrightsville Beach is part of Wilmington, North Carolina. About a month from now, maybe even less than that, this place will probably get hit by one of those really bad hurricanes. Always happens in September. Right now we're in August. And of course you have your side streets with all those seashore type homes that run for miles and miles and miles. Now where I'm standing right now, Burlington, is about, probably about 140 some miles from here, or in other words, it's way over there, about 3 hours away. Is that cactus? Ah, that's a palm tree. And look at the top there. It appears that Wilmington is going to get some rain. So I'm going to go to my next point of interest and kind of pick up where I left off there. By the way, those parking meters, 25 cents for 15 minutes. That's why I said earlier, I'm going to be here for 45 minutes. And of course, you know, there has to be an inlet to every seashore town also. Wrightsville Beach is no exception. Here's where I was, right over there a few minutes ago. There's the drawbridge going into the beach area. Just like Stone Harbor, New Jersey has. I have now made my way to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. I'm going to be here tonight for a Carolina League baseball game between the Myrtle Beach Pelicans and the Kinston Indians. Ballpark is about 5 blocks from here. This is Ocean Boulevard at 16th Street. The ballpark is on 21st. Right through those two hotels right there is the ocean. Look at this place. Got a nice front to it. There's the ocean. This is really neat. We got these high-rise hotels right here on the beach. The palm trees, which I earlier referred to as cactus. Sort of like Miami Beach. There's that high rise again. Can you imagine being way up there and having a view of the ocean? Olympic Flame Pancake House. Now, after I got done on Ocean Boulevard, I came out to Route 17 out by the stadium, and I saw this triangle or pyramid shaped place. Is it a pyramid? No. It's the Hard Rock Cafe. They even got one of them down there. Not to be outdone, right next door to the Hard Rock Cafe is the Planet Hollywood. You see the little bit of red there on the left, that's their sign. There we go, got a better view now. Planet Hollywood. Ninth Street. And the Hard Rock Cafe. And now it's off to the ballpark. Right next to the Hard Rock, you have the Myrtle Beach Aquarium. Here it is, Coastal Field, where I will see the game between the Myrtle Beach Pelicans and the Kinston Indians. Parked a little further away, so it'll be easier to get out after the game. I got a 5-hour ride to my hotel. Kinston out there taking batting practice. The Myrtle Beach emblem right there. Playing some pretty good music on that thing. The guards are dressed in, the ushers. Pretty neat uniforms, huh? I'm in the first row, section 207, right behind first base. Game be starting in about 15 minutes. Let's go.
number two, Raphael Furkoff. Coming second, playing second base, number 22, Marcus Giles. Ninth third, playing center field, number 7, Junior Brignac. And then cleanup, the designated hitter, number 24, Mark Fordover. Ninth fifth, playing left field, number 26, Jeff Spencer. Ninth sixth, playing first base, number 20, Ryan. Playing third base, number 32, Mike Hesman. Playing right field, eight, number 16, Jared Wall. And batting ninth, behind the plate for your Pelicans, number 8, Steve Grielba. On the hill tonight for your Pelicans, with a record of 6-5. Shield. Trainer for your Pelicans is Mike Krause. Hitting coach number 23, Dan Norman. Pitching coach number 43, Bruce Del Canton. And manager for your Pelicans, number 38, Brian Snicker.
Stripes and bright stars through the past.
mascot.
Let me hear you. Let's all join in. A one, a two, a three. Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. I need something as a Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I ever get back, for it's recruit for the home team.
In Kinston, middle of the seventh. This is the concession area down here at Coastal Federal Field. They have a team store right in here. You can buy souvenirs. Right out there and to the right is where the parking lot is. That's where I'm parked at. And this here leads up to the seating area. My section is just to the right of where we are right now.
How's it doing, man?
For the end of the game tonight. It all depends when it ends. If it's nine innings, I will. If it's more than that, I won't. And that's because I have a 5-hour drive to my hotel. Game should end around 9:30, so I'll be pretty close to 3 a.m. by the time I get back to my hotel. So I'm only going to stay until the end of 9. Right now, Kinston's leading 1-0, so might end after the top half of the ninth, or it might be the bottom half of the ninth. But that'll be it for me.
Pelicans just tied the game at 1-1.
Thank you.
safe. Bases are loaded. See, either they're going to go ahead right now or it's going to go into the ninth tied. And I'm going to call it a day at the end of this half inning. Well, 1-1 at the end of eight. That's it for me. Let's hope the Pelicans win. Well, that's it for me from Coastal Federal Field here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. It's going into the top of the ninth with a score tied at 1. This game could go extra innings, and I got a long drive to my hotel, so I'm going to catch the rest of it on the radio. Hopefully the Pelicans will win. This is all right behind the right field wall here. There's that Budweiser bar. And you can see the scoreboard right in through the trees there, barely. It's a pretty neat stadium. And a great sound system. Now you see that fancy looking diner way down there? That is a Denny's, believe it or not. This is in North Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, a Denny's. Well, folks, it's Thursday. I'm on my way home. The end of another vacation. It was a good vacation. I only stayed down in this area about 6 days, but man, time drug. It really went by slow. And I made the vacation seem a lot longer than what it was. I've already made the track from where I was in North Carolina up into Virginia, and the nearer I'm about maybe 10 miles from where I was last weekend. I'm just outside a town called Troutville, which is the next city above Roanoke, which is the next city above Salem. And one place I'll always remember while I'm here, this restaurant called Country Cooking, or as they would say, Country Cooking. They give you more than you can eat for about $5. I could not finish my meal in here. It was so big. So now with a full stomach, I will head home. And, well,
reminisce about the vacation that has just ended. Had a great time. Saw about 5 or 6 baseball games. And met a lot of new people. From Interstate 81, just outside of Troutville, Virginia. See,